Yoweri Museveni's remarks today, and the clouds are gathering around social media bloggers who are leading speculation about his health and life. Today, the president said that the police is going to crack down on all those social media bloggers who are speculating that he's dead and causing tension in the country. The president also says the Allied Democratic Forces, or ADF, that operates in the east of the Democratic Republic of Congo should surrender or the army will capture them. The president also notes that already terrorists that are disturbing the country have been silenced and that security is good. Let's have the details in the following report.
On June 21st, when the new cabinet was inaugurated, 16 ministers did not make it to Kololo after they were exposed to COVID-19. Today, 13 of them, including 6 cabinet ministers and 7 ministers of state, were sworn in to become full members of the cabinet. They include Doka Babalanda, the minister for the presidency, Monica Musenero, the minister of science, technology and innovations, Attorney General Kirio Wachiwanuka, Minister of Lands Judith Nabakoba, among others. The embattled Alice Kaboyo, the State Minister for Luwero Triangle, whose appointment was earlier rejected by Parliament's Appointments Committee, has also finally been sworn in.
I, Karamuzi Alice Kaboyo, swear in the name of Almighty God that I will be faithful and bear true allegiance to the Republic of Uganda, and that I will preserve, protect and defend the Constitution, so help me God.
In his address, President Yoweri Museveni, who officiated at the function, scoffed at the spate of social media reports which are pronouncing him dead. He directed the security agencies to arrest the racket of bloggers who announced his death to cause tension in the country.
Another problem we need to solve, I don't think it is a security problem, but it is an idiotic problem. The social media apparently has been saying that Museveni is dead. Now, the other day when I went to side of Bombo to lay a foundation stone, people were looking really, very, because they thought they had been told by social media that Museveni is dead or something like that. So the security service needs also to solve that problem. I need to check with them to locate quickly the one who tells such a story, because you waste people's time. They should go for you.
Museveni noted that security agencies have managed to break down the ADF group, which has been behind series of murders and terror attacks around the country. He told terrorists who are still at large to surrender before they are put out of action by security operatives.
Terrorists, please, I warn you, don't run. If we come, surrender. If you try to run, you are dead. You have been looking for trouble, now you are going to get it. You have been killing, you are now going to die. Your only way is to surrender. Even this looking for you, because in the looking we may get you and you don't get out. But if you surrender for us, we never kill people.
The president has also hailed the COVID-19 national lockdown for reducing the spread of the deadly virus. He noted that in the 3 weeks, COVID-19 cases have reduced drastically and the transition rate has dropped tremendously.
From what I'm hearing, the lockdown is already slowing down the spread. The other day I was in the cabinet and I was told that, the lockdown is working. I said, why? They said before the lockdown, when you would check 100 people for corona, 17 of them would be positive. Would be having the virus. But now, this was a few days ago, because of the lockdown, when we check 100 people, we found that only 8 or up to 10 are positive.
The newly sworn in ministers made their commitments.
We shall not lose cases out of recklessness. About the issue of staffing, we shall do our best with what we have, and if there is need for more staff, we'll consider that. But I believe that there is so much that we can do with the little staff that we have, with the small amount of staff that we have, just based on how organized you are. So we really must start trying to work within the means of what we have.
I'm going to bring on board a completely new angle to science, technology and innovation. You know, it is the president's desire to transform the economy. We cannot transform the economy working at the level at which we have been working.
There are so many things for me to handle. First of all, the biggest challenge that I must handle is the backlog. There's a huge backlog that must be handled in that ministry. We have our ex-servicemen. These are people who have served this country. Now they have retired, they are at home. They need to pay their pension. They need to settle down.
But still, there are other ministers, including Mururi Mukasa of Public Service, Sam Cheptoris of Environment, and State Minister for Agriculture, Fred Wino Chakulia, who have not yet taken oath.